A respiratory physiotherapist is a physio who has experience in treating respiratory conditions such as bronchiectasis. They may work in the hospital wards, in pulmonary rehabilitation, or even in a respiratory private practice. All physios will have learnt about airway clearance, but most physios will have become specialised over time. And so it is always best to have an experienced respiratory physio teach you about airway clearance techniques. The best way to find a respiratory physio is to ask the Lung Foundation or to call the physio department at your closest hospital and ask for advice. You can also get a referral from your GP to come to see us in the hospital.
So active cycle of breathing is a technique designed to help move mucus from deep in the lungs to higher up from where it can be easily coughed up. It consists of four parts: the deep breathing, the relaxed breathing, the huffing, and the coughing. So the deep breathing acts like a broom to sweep mucus from the deeper parts of the lung up higher. The relaxed breathing allows the small airways to return to normal width so the patient's not getting too wheezy. The huff really moves mucus from high in the chest to the back of the throat from where it can be finally coughed out. But over-coughing will stop the mucus coming up and make you feel very tight in the chest. So it's very important to use this whole technique, not just coughing. Active cycle of breathing can be done in a number of positions, and the position will depend very much on your lung condition. Your physio will explain which position is best for you. Yes, it's best to be taught this technique by a physio, a respiratory physio, because they will need to listen to your chest, as well as look at your CT scan and your chest x-rays, but also ask you some specific questions about what positions make you cough and so on. So this way, you'll have the most effective treatment for you if you talk to a respiratory physio.
If you have a lot of sputum and need to do daily chest physio, a device can help improve the effectiveness of the treatment. Different devices work in different ways. The PEP device helps to splint open the airways and remove plaggy mucus. The flutter devices help the cilia, which are the little hairs in the airways, to beat better and move the mucus more effectively. Devices can also help you focus on your treatment so it is easier for you. Never buy a device without getting help from a physio. Not everyone needs a device. Some people have a small amount of mucus that clears easily, or mucus that is on and off during the year. Example, people with COPD, asthma, or bronchitis. However, people with bronchiectasis need a device because they usually have a lot of mucus, and daily airways clearance is an essential part of their management. Good airway clearance prevents frequent infections and keeps you out of hospital.
Staying hydrated is general good health advice. If you are dehydrated, the mucus in your lungs can dry out and become harder to clear. If you are on a fluid restriction, such as somebody with heart failure, you need to speak to your GP because you will have to keep within the fluid limit that you've been prescribed. So make sure you know what it is. But general advice, drink water to stay healthy.